So it's officially the 1 year anniversary of Playboi Carti's Whole Lotta Red album, which also means that it's Christmas. So Merry Christmas and Happy Holidays to all of our viewers. And speaking on this album, today we'll be tackling, is this album overrated or is it overhated? Because it's one of the most polarizing albums that we've gotten in recent memory. Some fans think that it's one of the most overrated projects in a long time and that it's sitting at the bottom of his catalog, while other fans think that it's the best album of the millennium and that it's far ahead of its time. And they'll go as far to say that the real discovery that Neil Armstrong made when he landed on the moon was this old dusty vinyl of Whole Lotta Red that was kept in this time capsule until the year 2020. So, and show them the actual vinyl that we have right here.
Absolutely. So guys, listen, in our award show on December 29th, next Wednesday, we will be giving away this vinyl of Whole Lotta Red, plus two other vinyls, which are going to keep a surprise until the award show. And then this is actually a really nice vinyl, man. Now looking at it, I really like the album cover.
It's an okay cover, yeah.
I like it. I think it's original, and I think that it actually fits the aesthetic of the track list. So guys, if you want a chance to win this, come into our award show next Wednesday, 9:30 p.m. Eastern time. Put it into your calendars. It's going to be a major event. Lou and I put together all kinds of different categories, and we're going to be going through them in an actual live stream. So next Wednesday, 9:30 p.m. Eastern time, I hope to see you guys there. And this is an interesting conversation because when you're looking at, you know, this album, there's a lot of different questions around it. And that's the way we're going to be tackling this new series, Overrated, Overhated. It's, you know, going through the motions of the album. So the first, you know, sort of, I would say, criteria or conversation is, how is this album aged? How is it, you know, stuck through our rotations? What do we think about the sounds? And how is it overall, you know, let's say, had an impact on our listening over the past year? The next one that we're going to be going through is kind of the album experience and like the big takeaways of the album. So kind of saying, like, you know, what sort of sounds are, you know, lying within this project? You know, where did he strive sonically? And then the last one we're actually going to be talking about is the catalog. You know, where does this rank within his catalog? And, you know, where did he upgrade from his previous projects, or where did he downgrade? And then finally, we're going to be getting into our final stance. Is it overrated or overhated? Or maybe we think it's, you know, perfectly
rated. And let us know your thoughts on the album in the comments, of course, because we know that this album has people on the left side and the right side. So we're curious to see how you feel about it. But let's jump right into this. We both had our first listening experience together on Christmas of last year. And going into it, we weren't really feeling it too much. We felt like the project was kind of bloated and the pacing wasn't that, you know, well done, because it felt like a bit of a drag to get through. So, I mean, take me through that first listen and how it's aged for you now.
Okay, this is a very interesting experience. And listen, if you guys have been a fan of the podcast, you guys know that I'm not a fan of this project, but I'm going to admit it right here, right now. I did not give this album enough of a fair chance, because right off the bat, I think on the first listen, I really wanted to hear that old Cash Carti experience. You know, I was such a big fan of Self-Titled. I was such a big fan of Die Lit. I wanted to see him return with that because, you know, I was a major Carti fan and I was a really big fan of those two projects. So I feel as if my first experience kind of went sour because I had too many expectations. And this is what kind of, you know, shaped my viewing of first listens and kind of got better with time. But I haven't really, you know, picked up this album throughout the year because that first experience for me was so disappointing. But we had to do this episode, right? And we had to go back into this piece of content. I re-listened to this, man, and I have to say, I really didn't judge this album fairly, especially that, you know, there's all kinds of new sounds that I have to go through. I feel as if there's different things going into it. So I feel as if my verdict with the rotation is that I didn't necessarily give it enough of a chance, so it hasn't been in my rotation long enough. But now that I've, you know, been getting into it slowly, slowly, I could see this actually creeping into my, you know, Carti listening experience. So I'm going to take it back to you. How do you feel about this album over the past year, and has anything changed after these couple of re-listens that you've done recently?
Yeah, well, I feel like, you know, for starters, that first listen was so tough just because it was a very rough transition going into what Carti was doing on his Self-Titled and Die Lit, moving into Whole Lotta Red. It was kind of very different, and the fact that he chose to rebrand and kind of switch up his style for a lot of the tracks made it kind of hard to adjust to this new sound because we had never gotten it, you know, from Carti before. Apart from that, I mean, to be totally honest with you guys, this is an album that hasn't stuck in my rotation at all. And just the fact that I haven't felt or, you know, been inclined to go back to the music kind of speaks volumes to me, even though that I'm kind of judging this off of the first two listens I had. But going into it now again, I am appreciating more of the strengths. I'm realizing that there's things that I maybe took for granted within the track list, while I also do feel the same about certain, I would say, you know, takeaways from the project
and
itself.
And I have a
too.
Question for yeah. you, okay? Because the biggest thing with this album is that I believe it clocks in at 24 songs, yes? And it's over an hour listen time. So do you think that that was maybe a recipe for you maybe having to put this album down and not necessarily revisiting that start to finish over again as maybe you'd like to with other Carti projects?
100%, because with Playboi Carti self-titled, you know, it's 15 songs. Same thing with Dilit, 19 tracks. I'll go in from start to finish and I'll just vibe out and it feels like this very consistent soundscape. But with Whole Lotta Red, sounds are a bit all over the place and those 24 tracks make it very hard for me to sit through, especially, you know, considering, yeah, the length of the tracks too. But I would just say that, you know, for the most part, it's one of those projects where I've kind of plucked out certain tracks but not gone through from start to finish. But speaking of the album, let's now go into the major takeaways from the album and how we feel now that we've had, you know, more listens on it. So going into this, take me through kind of how you felt about, you know, Carti himself and what he was able to, you know, change from the previous project.
Yeah, and I really understood this on the last couple of listens that I did because he obviously steered away from the Cash Carti sound. That's the first thing that you're going to realize with this project is that it's a completely different rebrand. And I feel as if sonically, it's a much different soundscape than anything you've ever gotten on a Carti project because looking back at self-titled and then looking back at, you know, Dilit, there was that consistency within the Cash Carti sound. There was more of a Zelda bouncy sort of vibe. It was mostly, you know, centered around, you know, Pierre Bourne's production. Whereas of this, you know, the drums were much quicker. I found there was darker synths with a mix of EDM synths at certain points as well. And going into Carti's performance, you got a lot more screaming. You got a lot more of aggressive deliveries while, you know, still being able to, let's say, carry certain melodic performances. Well, not melodic, I'd say softer performances on songs like Bino, Slayer, New Neon, Control. Then I also love, you know, the sort of energy that he comes in with on songs like Go to the Moon, Rockstar Made, New Tank, Control, Sky. These are all really nice songs that pack that punch, but I don't know how I feel about the screaming, bro. Like, that's my biggest thing within Carti's performance.
That aggressive
with
delivery, eh?
It's yeah. a bit much. Example, on songs like Stop Breathing, which I know is a, you know, is a really big favorite for the fans, but it's just like, is it executed well? Like, that was my question when I was listening to songs like that. And to be honest with you, I think maybe that's where the weakness within this track list lies, is that sometimes that aggressive and screaming delivery feels a bit forced. It doesn't necessarily mesh well with the production
choices. And
it's
just not pleasant to the ear, right? Like, we're listening to that and we're kind of thinking, like, you know, these notes are not being hit well. It sounds kind of out of pitch. It sounds kind of out of whack. And to be honest, that's kind of the way I feel for all of his screamo delivery throughout the entire project. And to be honest with you, in terms of, let's say, the major takeaways from the album, I just feel like a lot of the ideas are half-baked. I feel like he kind of went halfway with the concept because even though Pierre Bourne's only on 2 out of the 24 tracks in terms of production, you have producers like Art Dealer, for example, that are kind of keeping that formula of older projects alive by having those electronic sounding synths and these video game-esque sound effects. And
some
clipping
808s too and stuff.
Which is also very present in Dilit and other projects. So I feel like in terms of, you know, songs like Vamp Anthem, where you have, let's say, this classic organ that feels like it's 1970s horror inspired, that part of it is cool because I'm like, okay, you know what? Carti's actually fully diving into this Vamp persona and aesthetic, but I would say a good half of the track list is him going back to what he's already given us. And and to be honest with you, he executes on those songs like Bino, Slayer, Over, Play, Sky. He executes on those songs much better because it's the Carti that I know and I feel like he has more room to have these more interesting flows. But when it's on the other side of the spectrum, it's more innovative, but it's also not pleasant to the ear at all.
I get what you're saying, and it's also, I think, because you're so accustomed to, let's say, Carti's Cash Carti sound.
It doesn't matter though.
I feel as if
it's not clouding my judgment. I just think that he's not executing well, and I think that those songs where he's kind of having, let's say, you know, his own spelling bee, like he spells out Draco, D-R-A-C-O, and that kind of makes up the hook. It's just lazy. It's low effort, and it's not as entertaining as some of the catchier hooks that I would have found on songs like Woke Up Like This or Half and Half, or you know, even songs like Flatbed Freestyle.
I get you on that, and I understand the gripe with it, but the thing that I found on the second listen is that I feel as if he kind of had to do that because he can't necessarily completely strip down his sound and go full with it.
He could have, yeah.
I mean, do you really want that for 24 songs on this? Like, that was another...
I don't want 24 songs, period, bro. That's the whole point, is that the track list is bloated.
Okay, but
like,
let's
he could have made the Focus Vamp album in maybe 12 songs. That would have been cool. I would have appreciated that. What I do like, though, I'll tell you this, and this is a point that you brought up already, is the fact of how dynamic his vocal performance is, because he changes the energy from hype to aggressive to softer and sweeter. So I like how all over the place he was in that aspect, but I mean, apart from that, I mean, it just wasn't it.
Well, I mean, looking at my biggest two takeaways with this album, at least on the positive side of things, is that I feel as if, you know, I could understand where you're coming from with, like, let's say some lazy hooks, but I actually think that there was a fuckload of effort put in by Carti into this project because of the amount of energy there is within it. Like, it seems like he's just going at it, and that was something I didn't necessarily appreciate on my first couple of listens, but now that I'm like, oh, okay, you know what? Like, I like it. I kind of feel where he's going with this, and I understand the vision of it.
But you know what? It sounds like you understand the vision, but you don't like the execution, which is my whole issue with it, because if we're being honest with ourselves... The screamo delivery.
Yes. Okay. Let's say yes. I'm not necessarily the biggest fan of the way that it's delivered. I could kind of see myself having to listen to this again and maybe go deeper with it, like understand where it's at. Like, that's how I feel about Whole Lotta Red as a whole, is that I just didn't give it a fair chance. I never really, that first listening experience was so out of tune for me that I never necessarily went into it deeper. But I want to say this though. I feel as if this is, you know, one of Carti's best produced projects. Like, that's hands down. Like, the production on this album It's fucking amazing, bro. Like, there's actually not a single miss as far as beats go on this album. The soundscape is so dynamic, it's a bit darker, it's more fast paced. The fact that that Carti's challenging himself on going maybe, you know, with these newer, you know, more dynamic productions is something that I like to see, and that was something that I grabbed out of the track list, is this soundscape is fucking amazing. Plus, let me say this, all right, there are so many fucking people biting the sound right now, because think about it, Carti introduced this new and addicting sound. Well, maybe you could say it's Art Dealer or whoever else, you know, it like took care of the project, but it works in the way because it keeps you gravitated towards that project. Like, that was something else that I picked up on, is that sound is so ear grabbing and it's so pulling that you don't want to necessarily put down the album. And that was something that I found within my replay. So, you know, talk to me about the production and talk to me how you're feeling about it
now. I think the producers did a great job at capturing the mood that, you know, Carti wanted to encompass, you know, per song. Like, Stop Breathing has that horror vibe. A song like Control, you know, kind of feels like it has remnants of electro pop, and it kind of sounds like Just Dance from Lady Gaga because of those electronic synths and that kind of EDM inspired sound that you would have. But overall, I would say the melodies are kind of drone based, like they were on previous Carti projects.
Facts.
That kind of stayed the same. You have the distorted 808s and bass that is so heavy and prominent, like it was in previous Carti projects. So you do have, let's say, maybe harder hitting drums at times, or songs that I would say have more, I would say maybe more of a darker and more horror-esque vibe, but overall, there's only a mix of that, and I would have wanted that to be prominent throughout the whole track list. And to me, the features were kind of not well chosen out. I like the fact that he went and decided to have only 3 features out of 24 songs, but it's almost as if I got too much Carti. I wanted something that was more refreshing, and I think the features that he chose didn't even suit the style that he was going for the sound of the project, in the sense of, you know what I mean? This is kind of viewed as a punk album. Why not get artists that go into that lane? Why not work with artists like Denzel Curry? Why not work with artists like, I would say, Ski Mask the Slump God? I think they would have been better fits than having Kanye West, Kid Cudi, and Future, despite me liking some of those features.
All right, listen, I like the features. I agree that maybe they were a bit miscalculated, but Kid Cudi absolutely slid. I mean, his vocals were fucking amazing. The humming was really nice, and I also like Kanye West on Go to the Moon. Like, that was a really nice performance, full of energy. The Future one was kind of forgettable, in my opinion, but
listen, bro, if you slap Lil Uzi on a song like New Noon, I mean, you have that light and playful vibe that they had on Shooter. Like, there were so many opportunities. New Neon?
Yeah, New Neon.
My bad. But anyways, you have so many opportunities to kind of, you know, to showcase your chemistry with other artists that are kind of playing within that emo rap punk, you know, lane. So why not do it instead of working with an artist like Future? But let's now go into how it kind of fits into Carti's discography. And we're not going to spend too much time on this one because we do have a discography ranking out on the channel. But, you know, point blank, I think that it sits at the bottom of his catalog. I think that With this album, it felt like I was in a car ride with Carti, but at certain tracks, he would open the door and throw me out of the car and then pick me up later on and throw me out again, because I feel like the track list was all over the place. It didn't feel focused. It felt like the ideas were half-baked. And with other Carti projects, I feel like it was kind of an introduction into his world and his sound. And the soundscape was more blissful. It was more euphoric. It felt intoxicating. He really pulled me and entertained me for the entire length of the track list. While for this one, it kind of had, you know, some breaks and some weird moments in between. So that's kind of how I feel about it, and I feel like it's his worst project.
You guys already know my discography ranking. I think that this place is within the bottom of his discography, and I don't think that's up for debate, because Self-Titled and Dialit are way too good. Like, those are
amazing
really
projects.
Those are amazing projects, and I think that, you know, that's necessarily where I was wrong with this project too, because I was too concentrated on, you know, the fact that he had dropped two fantastic projects before this. And looking at Whole Lotta Red, I do think it's at the bottom of his discography, but I don't think that it's necessarily a knock on him. I think that within his discography, it's one of the most dynamic produced soundscapes that I've heard from him ever. I also think that it's the most high voltage energy that I've ever heard Carti go. So I think that there is strengths with this album when you're looking at the overall grand scheme of things. But one thing I do agree with you with is that maybe it has to be more focused and contextualized, because, you know, you got that sort of cohesion on albums like, you know, Dialit and mixtapes like Self-Titled. So when you're looking at the overall, you know, landscape of the catalog, yes, this does fall into, you know, that bottom half for me. But also talking about that, like, he only has three projects out, you know, like, it's kind of like you got to give more time for his catalog to breed. Maybe I want to see where, you know, this is going to go also with, let's say, you know, other projects that he releases, because
it's kind of like a fork in the road for Carti.
That's like what I'm trying to say is like, where does he go after this with his catalog? And if you ask me as a personal fan, dude, keep running with it. Like, I don't think he should ever return to that Cash Carti sound, because it would get redundant, it would get stale, and it wouldn't necessarily fit my rotation. But with this new
vamp aesthetic,
there's a whole world to explore, and I'm already starting to see the impact of this album.
And,
so
yeah,
that's where I stand.
And I
with
think
this
that
catalog.
Because he didn't fully explore it on a Whole Lotta Red, there is that room to do it on a future project. But Carti has kind of upgraded his sound, or let's say experimented sonically with every project. So I don't want to see him lock into this vamp aesthetic and kind of run with it for the rest of his career either. I do want to see him tackling new sounds with every project. And to me, this just feels like Playboi Carti's Yeezus album, because this is the biggest sonic departure. It's his most polarizing album. But the difference is that what Kanye West did with Yeezus was that he had a full concept, and that it was, you know, kind of executed within 13 tracks. And it kind of had this whole character built up of this egotistical maniac, while with Carti's vamp aesthetic, that persona isn't really fully fleshed. The character development isn't there, but it does feel like Carti's Yeezus, in my opinion.
That's very true. I think that the fact that it's polarizing, and the fact that it was a complete different departure than what he's ever done before, yeah, it's actually a very good comparison. But I also think it's kind of, it's not necessarily fair to maybe compare those two albums, because I feel as if Kanye West, you know, is a much better writer than Playboi Carti, and I mean, can't even debate that. But I mean,
there's, you know, actually some interesting bars on this project.
There is, but I'm saying like,
I just hit a lick. With a mask, MF Doom. I thought that was pretty cool. Apart from that, I don't rap. I write poems. Also, they can't understand me. I'm talking hieroglyphics. So kind of cool to see him being aware of his mumbling delivery as he was in previous projects.
Yeah, but that's such,
you know,
a big staple within Carti's discography and everything that he's put out. Like, if you don't like it, you just simply
don't like it.
But overall, listen, I think that it's at the bottom of his catalog, but it doesn't necessarily dilute it. I still think that he has a super strong catalog. But okay, let's get into it, man. Official verdict. Overrated or overhated? How do you feel about it? And, you know, take me through that motion for you.
I think that some people, you know, consider this to be one of the best projects that we've gotten in recent years. I mean, to me, this project is simply overrated, guys. I think that people think that he has reinvented what it means, you know, to be in that trap lane and to actually create a new subgenre. And yes, you do hear on songs like Beano, let's say, some sounds of hyperpop, which have been introduced prior to this. You do hear kind of this punk aesthetic, which has been tackled prior to this. But I would say that it is refreshing to hear someone take a concept and idea that hasn't been done for quite some time and bring it back to mainstream hip hop. I think that Carti was very brave to do that, and it was a risk. It was a risk that did pay off. But nonetheless, I just feel like he kind of is trying too much. You know what I mean? He's kind of personifying this dangerous vampire. He's personifying this lover boy. He's personifying this being this famous celebrity all at the same time. And that whole idea of being a vampire and, you know, making an album that, you know, focuses on that concept is half baked. It feels like he went halfway with the vision and didn't fully execute on it. So in my opinion, it's an overrated album. People treat it like it's the new fucking Illmatic, and I just can't do it, bro.
No. It's definitely, like, listen, I'm going to start off by saying it's overrated, but I don't think that's a knock towards the album, because as I've gotten deeper with it and as I've given it more listens, those qualities in the album are super prominent. So stuff like the production, you know, Carti's high voltage energy, the prominent tracks within it. Like, I feel as if this is a fun listen now. Like, as of before, I wasn't necessarily able to go from 1 to 24 and really stick with it. But I think overall, like, I've seen people call this, like, better than MBDTF. Like, I can't.
I think people like to troll with this album. I think that's what it comes down to.
I don't know if it's
to.
Trolling or if it's honest belief. Like, that's my thing with it. Is like, where do you sort of draw the line, and where do you say, like, listen, you know, like, this is not
it's kind,
on that top
quality. You
know what
quality. It is? It's kind of become that album that people love to overrate because it pisses other people off, because people are on totally, you know, two different sides of the spectrum. But one last thing I want to touch upon is kind of the influence that we're seeing, not only from Whole Lotta Red, but from Carti's sound in general. I mean, if you look at a lot of the up and coming artists, such as Cash Dami, Yeet, you know, Kooch Ice, Lancey Fu, you know, Sofago, a lot of these artists are kind of being inspired by, let's say, this rage sound and the many diverse vocal styles that Carti projects on this project. And it kind of started on Whole Lotta Red, it got fully developed onto a song like Mr. Rage, and now we're seeing a lot of artists tackling these sounds. So it's too early to say if this influence will come and, you know, make something good out of it. We're not sure if it'll be a good influence or a bad influence for hip hop, but the fact that he's touched so many people, the fact that it's reached so many people, and the album's almost sitting at a billion streams on Spotify shows that people are gravitating towards the project. But in my opinion, Carti has put out better projects that have been more focused, and this one was just not it for me.
Okay, but listen, I'm going to say it's overrated, but guys, listen, I'm trying to give it a chance. I'm actually trying to go through this and understand where you guys are coming from, because I'm starting to slowly understand the qualities within it. I don't think it's a bad project anymore. I actually think it's good. I think that it was a good listen.
I think it's a mid-album.
Lou thinks it's a mid-album, but guys, listen, we hope you like this episode. Merry Christmas to you guys, and thank you so much for everything you've done for us over the past year. Listen, guys, major event next week, Wednesday, December 29th. Big award show. As I said, we're going to be giving away a copy of Whole Lotta Red by Playboi Carti. We hope you guys are going to have fun, and we hope to see you guys there. And listen, guys, in the comment section, let us know some different reasons for why you think this album would be overrated or overhated. You know, I like to always talk with you guys and see your opinions, but thank you so much for watching this video, and we'll catch you on the next one.
Thanks for watching the full video, and if you're new to NFR, be sure to hit that subscribe button, as we'll be keeping you guys updated with the latest album releases in terms of update videos, album reviews, and our own original series on the weekly. And we also have our Patreon plan available in the description below, where you can access weekly bonus content and also access to our Discord. So be sure to check out all of that, and we'll catch you in the next one.